I have a little surprise today. Quilt journals. Okay, this has been something that's kind of been in my head for like a year, and I finally took the time and got it done. I haven't spoken about this yet, but I'm really, really excited about it. So the idea is to have a record of the quilts I've made for so that I'll have a record, you know, but also because I tend to forget things. Like for instance, background fabric. What did I use for background fabric? That's my easiest thing for me to forget. Sometimes I'll make a quilt, I'll use one of our backgrounds in it, and then we'll make kits for it. I get a whole bunch of emails or messages asking me which background did I use for it, and then I have no memory of which background I use. So I'll have to get up, I'll have to go and try to match it to one of our solids. That is one of the reasons I wanted this journal. Another reason is my work in progress quilt, or my WIPs, or UFOs, whatever you call them. Sometimes mine sit for a while and I'll forget things, as always. I wanted to have these journals so that would quit happening to me. So let's have a look inside of these.
All right, so we have them in two different colors, the blush and the sage, and then they're kind of color coordinated. I'm going to show you each of them, but we'll start with this one because it's my favorite. All right, so front, back, it's got the wire bound so that, you know, you can do one of these numbers, right? And then it's the outside is the same type of cover as my book, if you have a copy of A Life with Quilts. The inside paper, though, is a little bit thinner because, you know, you have to be able to write on it. So here's how it starts out, and we've got contents, and then it's got some about you type stuff. So you got your goals, you got your patterns that you have, a place to put your style. I've added this because for me, once you decide the things that you like, that make your heart sing about quilting, it's easier to choose fabrics. So if you just go by that you think that's pretty, there's a lot of things that I think are pretty that are still not, just because they're pretty doesn't mean they're for me. So that's what this whole thing is trying to figure out that for you, so that then you can make things that you want to make and always like them, always be happy with those quilts that you make. And then here's the main parts. All right, so this is what the whole journal is really about, is this this recording, record, log, whatever you want to call it. And there's a place for 20 quilts. So 1, 2, 3, it just continues on all the way up to 20. So you could record 20 quilts in these journals. And it's got, you know, quilt name, the date you began, the date you completed it. It's got this checklist, which I think would be really, really handy for works in progress, like your WIPs or your UFOs. I think this would be best for that. And then here is where you would list your fabrics, right? I use this for foreground. I use this for background. That is the part that I wanted the most. And then it's got, you know, a place for extra things like notions and supplies you have, you need. Like, let's say you purchased a pattern and then you realize that you've got to have a special ruler for it. That would be, you know, something that you would put in this section here. And then you've got some planning parts where this is where you would put your fabric swatches if you needed to. It's got who you made this quilt for, or it could be just for you, you know, whatever, occasion, or you could save this for if you gifted it, you could put that here. Or if you're planning on making something for someone, it's got, you know, the need by date, so you could have that there. I've got a place for you to put your long armor if you used one, just because I like to remember that when I use a long armor, who did it. And the design motif, in case you liked that motif and you want to have it on a quilt again in the future. And then I've left this space right here for you to write in, you know, what you learned, what you struggled with, what you hope to improve, you know, basically a little quilt story. Right here is where you would put a picture of the finished quilt if you wanted to. And then, you know, your mood. So that's what This is the parts in the quilt, in the book, in the journal that I wanted the most. Like I said, there's 20 of these. And then towards the back, it's got some cheat sheets. All right, so I don't know. So if you haven't taken my precision course, everything that came with the precision course as far as PDFs is also included. Just to get your precision better, if you need that help, it's here. It's got a half square triangle cheat sheet, how many squares you can get out of a certain piece of fabric, common size quilts, fat quarter diagram, how the fat eighth, fat quarter, in case you need that. And that's it. That's what it has. And like I said, you would use this for per 20 quilts. So when I fill this up with my next 20 quilts, you know, I'll grab me another one. And let me just show you the one that's in green, because it's got some different colorings to it. So this one has got, where that one is all very blush and berry, this one is very tan and green. So same thing, just different looking colors. All right, and that is the quilt journal.
So these are currently available to pre-order, and they're coming in pretty quick. We're expecting them to start shipping on August 31st. There's a little discount on them right now for pre-ordering. You can do that at meanderandmake.com. In the future, you're going to see me using these journals, showing you what I write in certain sections. I'll definitely do a video where I record one of my quilts, things like that. I'm going to go now and get all that ready, actually. I'm going to put all my whips in this book and write down the things I can remember for those, and then I will be popping in here and showing you little bits about the journal in the future. All right, so that is all today. Thank you for watching.